Welcome. In this video, we'll take a closer look at the structure of a typical NIH Notice of Funding Opportunity, which we refer to as a NOFO or simply a funding opportunity. As a reminder, you can find NIH funding opportunities in the NIH Guide for Grants and Contracts on the grants.nih.gov website. Each funding opportunity has the same basic structure. Part 1 contains overview information and key dates. Part 2 has detailed information with sections for description, award information, eligibility, application and submission, application review information, award administration, and agency contacts. Let's take a look at one of our requests for applications as an example. At the top in Part 1, you'll find all the participating organizations with links to their websites. Make sure your proposal fits within the mission of one of the institutes or centers listed in the funding opportunity. Scrolling down, you'll find the funding opportunity title. Most titles include the activity code and an indication of whether clinical trials are allowed. The three-character activity code used to identify the program, in this case, R01, is repeated in its own field. The announcement type indicates whether it's a new initiative or a reissue of a previous opportunity. The related notices section includes policy updates and any corrective notices. A unique funding opportunity number is assigned to each opportunity. You'll use this number within your submission system to identify the opportunity in application forms. The companion funding opportunity section includes other NOFOs within the same initiative that vary by activity code or clinical trial indicator. There is a high-level summary of the funding opportunity purpose, the funding opportunity goals, which align with the objectives of the issuing institute, and then a key date section. The open date is the first date our systems will accept applications. It's typically 30 days before the due date. Letters of intent are not required, though they are helpful for planning purposes. When requested, we typically ask for letters of intent at least 30 days prior to the due date. In most opportunities, the key dates section includes a table of application due dates. Pick an application due date and read across that row to find the related dates. Application due dates may vary based on the application type. For instance, whether your proposal is a new application, a renewal, resubmission, or revision, and whether activities are AIDS related. The review dates indicate when NIH conducts its two levels of scientific review. The earliest start date is the earliest anticipated date for awards to begin. The expiration date is typically the day after the last available due date. Note that our systems are configured to accept applications for a short time beyond the expiration date, in accordance with our continuous submission, late application, and system issue policies. These submission policies can be found on our website. The NOFO includes a link to our application guide. Applicants must follow the standard guidance in the application guide, as well as the opportunity-specific guidance in the NOFO and any related notices. If the opportunity-specific instructions in the NOFO conflict with the standard instructions in the application guide, then the NOFO wins. If instructions in a guide notice conflict with either the application guide or the NOFO, the notice wins. Just above the table of contents, you will find the available options to access, prepare, and submit your application. All NIH applications must be prepared and submitted electronically through one of the listed options. For most opportunities, the options include NIH's Assist, an institutional system-to-system solution, and grants.gov workspace. Note, our large multi-project opportunities only include Assist and institutional S2S solutions, since grants.gov workspace does not support our more complex opportunities. Part 2 contains the full text of the announcement. Section 1 Notice of Funding Opportunity Description includes the full description of the NOFO, relevant background, and research objectives. It may also include criteria that would make an application non-responsive to the opportunity. If your application includes non-responsive criteria, it's a good idea to reach out to the scientific research contact to discuss your proposal and its fit within the opportunity. Section 2 has award information. It indicates the funding instrument, typically a grant or cooperative agreement, the application types allowed, in this case, new, renewal, resubmission, and revision, with a glossary link to explain the various types. Any application that includes one or more clinical trials must be submitted to a NOFO that allows them. The clinical trial indicator will display one of four options: not allowed, required, optional, or required basic experimental studies with humans, also known as BESH. If applying to a BESH NOFO, your clinical trial must also meet NIH's definition of basic research, which you can also find in the glossary on our site. In the Funds Available and Anticipated Number of Awards section, program announcements with set-aside funds, PASs, and requests for applications, RFAs, like our example, include the anticipated number of awards and budget commitment. In award budget, you'll find any direct cost or project period limits. Award project periods vary by program, with most being 5 years or less. Moving on to Section 3, Eligibility, we list the types of eligible organizations. NIH recognizes the applicant organization as the recipient for most programs, not an individual. We clearly indicate whether foreign organizations are eligible, and we summarize required registrations. We then outline any eligibility requirements of the program or project director principal investigator, also known as the PDPI. The PDPIs are responsible for directing the work supported by the award. Section 4, Application and Submission Information, is a very important section. All the forms presented through your submission system are listed, and with each form we provide any opportunity-specific instructions. There's a page limitation section that links to a standard table of page limits for application attachments and outlines any opportunity-specific additions or special limits. Section 4.4 includes important deadline reminders. For instance, submit early, clear any errors by the deadline, and check the final submitted application image in ERA Commons to ensure it made it through our systems and was formatted without any assembly errors. Section 4.6 informs applicants that awards are subject to the terms and conditions in the NIH Grants Policy Statement, which can be found on our website. Section 4.7 links to instructions for dealing with federal system issues that may threaten your on-time submission. We also include reminders for other submission requirements. You'll want to pay close attention to Section 5 Application Review Information. It includes the review criteria used to evaluate the scientific and technical merit of your application. Be sure your proposal clearly addresses each of the listed criteria. Section 5.2 describes the review and selection process. We take into consideration scientific and technical merit, availability of funds, and relevance to program priorities within the funding organization. Section 6, Award Administration Information, explains the award process. This is also where you'd find any award-specific provisions to be included in the Notice of Award. Section 6.3 and 6.4 explain data management sharing and other post-award reporting requirements. Section 7, Agency Contacts, provides application submission contacts, including the ERA service desk, who can help with system issues, scientific research contacts, who can answer your programmatic questions, peer review contacts who can discuss application review concerns, and financial grants management contacts who can answer your budget or grants administration questions. Thank you for watching. We hope this video helps you navigate our funding opportunities. Before applying, make sure to read your NOFO thoroughly to understand requirements. For additional information, check out the grants.nih.gov website. You can also reach out to the agency contacts listed in your NOFO if you need help with any step of the application. Good luck, and we look forward to seeing your applications.